So glad they made a stop here with us today. So let's welcome tonight Grace Wave. We give them applause tonight.
in the book, he gave unto man. And each page that I read, helps me understand to build on the rock. Oh, yes, it does, and not on the sand. Some people I know, they can't understand how I can go on and do his command. It's hard to explain the way that I feel. Church, I'll not complain. No, 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 for heaven is real.
Face to face. Amen. Thank you so much for having us. We appreciate privilege, what a pleasure. So nice to meet you. Willie talks about you guys all the time, and I finally get to kind of put a face with a name, since he was kind enough to let me come on the road with him. But I would like you to listen to Willie. He's my favorite singer, and he sings one of my favorite songs. Would you make him welcome tonight? As he sings, he whispers sweet peace.
I could not go on without him, I know. This world would overwhelm my soul. I could not see the right way. When temptation over me rolls, he whispers sweet peace to me. He whispers sweet peace to me. Spells on my fears, and when I am cast down and troubled in soul, that still small voice I circumstances, but they stood in such grace and such dignity because of the peace of God that covered them. I can't imagine what it would be like to have to say goodbye to one of my children. That would just tear me up. But there's people in this world, dear friends of ours. One I'm thinking of in particular, is both of his daughters have passed way before he's even close. And that's just a hard, and it wasn't anything they did, just one car accident, the other one had cancer. Just unbelievable circumstances. But he's still singing for the Lord.
Amen.
And he's still trusting in God. I know we talk often, and he says some days are terrible and some days are almost unbearable. He said, but I know where they're at, and that's where I'm going. And that's the peace that passes all understanding. The world doesn't understand. Only a believer knows. Amen? Amen. I'm going to take just a moment to introduce you wonderful folks to these two right here. This young lady right here standing beside me has been in my life since November of 1993 when we first met at a gospel concert at a homecoming at a little church in a little place called Pinckney, North Carolina. And I mean, it's in the country. But it's right up the road from the big metropolis of Nahunta. So if any of you have ever seen Nahunta sausage, well, she was from that area where it was raised and chopped up. Yeah. No, it where it's processed and shipped all over the country. But anyway, this is my lovely bride, Dana. Would you say hello to Dana this evening? Miss Dana Salt. And this old gentleman over here on the end, he's been singing most of his life, and he sang with, one of the biggest names in gospel music when this guy was probably, 16 years old? He was part of a group called the Singing Samaritans. And in that group, which was owned by our friend's father, in that group was a young man by the name of Michael English. And Michael would go on to become one of the biggest gospel singers. And he's now retired, lives in Nashville, and he's enjoying, I guess, just living the dream, as they say. But Ronald traveled with Mike for a few years, and he, matter of fact, we were over at Carol's and we found an old album of Singing Samaritans. Y'all ought to see that.
Buck teeth and all.
Yeah. I wanted to call him Ed, but I didn't want to upset him. Anyway, he is from Greenville, North Carolina, Mr. Ron Perry. Would you say hello to Ron? And Ron and myself both have been in and around quartet our whole musical lives. I love quartet singing. We had to adapt this song. It's a quartet song. It's straight up quartet song. But we adapted it so it would fit the trio. So we're going to do it for you, and I'll see if you can recognize the parts that we changed. And it's kind of a fun song to sing. I know you'll recognize it. I'm winging my way back home, okay? Down deep in my soul,
down deep in my soul,
a melody rings.
I'm winging my way back home.
A sinner is saved.
My spirit's now free.
I'm winging my way. to glory divine.
To glory divine.
The way is called straight.
So much. It is a pleasure. And you'll hear it each time either one of us talk. It's a pleasure for us to be here. We praise God for everything He's doing for us. We've only been together 5 months. And like Willie said, I've sung with numerous quartets, trios, so forth and so on. But back in 2012, I used to weigh about 400 pounds. I had a stroke. And the stroke actually withered my hand and down my left side. After months of rehab, they told me to get out and walk. So I took my walker and I was walking around my neighborhood. Finally graduated to a cane. And I thought to myself, well, this is good.
So I'm walking one day with my cane, and all of a sudden I hear something. It says to me, "Why are you dragging that foot?" I look around, there's nobody. Nobody, nowhere. I don't even see people on the porch. Didn't think much of it. Thought to myself, okay, it's a little scary, but I'm going on. And I kept walking. And I heard it again. "Why are you dragging that foot?" And this time I said, "Because I can't pick it up." That's the very words I said. And then in a sweet voice, "Have you tried?" And I couldn't answer that. And I said, "Well, no, I haven't tried." So I started picking up that foot. And I started walking. Well, it took a little while. But after a while, that foot straightened out. And I began to walk. Well, it won't long, the hand opened up. Folks, don't tell me we're not serving a good God. Because if you do, well, I'll sit down and talk with you anytime. I still have some numbness on my side. But I praise God every day for what He's done for me. I'm so thankful for the touch of God.
Just gone, roll away,
roll away,
roll away. For my
I won't be long. It's been 5 years. I had a saddle pulmonary embolism, which is just a big fancy word for I had a blood clot in my lung. It was right in the center of my lung. And to just really condense the story, it took weeks and weeks and weeks for them to diagnose what the problem was. I was short of breath. I didn't feel well. I was told I had anxiety. I mean, they just had all kinds of things that it was other than what it really was. And so they finally figured out what was going on. And by this time, it was pretty serious. My heart was damaged. My lungs are still damaged to this day. But during that whole journey, that really scary time, it was very scary for both of us. Willie was on the road all the time. He was gone with the Dixie Melody Boys Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. It was just a hard time. When I was in the hospital, I'd stay for a little while when they got everything situated and got it all figured out. It was a pretty scary time. And I went through a phase where I thought, well, I'm a Christian. I know the Lord. I shouldn't be scared. I mean, is this normal for me to be so scared? I should be confident in my relationship with the Lord. And I began to feel a little guilty for the fear that I was feeling. And so as I was hanging out in the hospital, through the entire event, he began to strategically place people in my life in the hospital that were Christians. The person that did the MRI was a Christian. The person that did the dye in the legs to check the blood clots was a Christian. And they volunteered this information. I didn't even have to ask them. They just opened up my chart and was surprised that I was still alive. And I said, well, the Lord is not through with me yet, so that is why I'm still here. And each person that I encountered in the hospital encouraged and lifted me up. And it didn't really dawn on me in that moment, but one of the last things that happened, the very last day I was in the hospital before they let me go home, the phone rang in the room, and you know, with cell phones, nobody ever calls the hospital room anymore. And I answered it, and Willie, by this time, he had to go on the road with the guys, and he was gone, so I was just by myself. And I answered the phone, and she said, is this Miss Sorry? And I said, yes, it is. She said, this is LabCorp. Does anybody know who LabCorp is? I don't know if y'all have LabCorp here. Okay. I wasn't sure if they were here. And I was like, you know, I'm still in the hospital. I'm sure I owe you money, and I promise I'll pay. I haven't gotten a bill yet. You know, I didn't know why. Why would they be calling me in the hospital? And the lady kind of chuckled, and she said, oh, no, ma'am. She said, I'm breaking all kinds of rules and laws right now by calling you, but I just had to see if you were still alive. Because she's the one that developed that final test that figured out what the problem was. And it was pretty scary. But she called to give me a word of encouragement. During that entire time, for years I've been singing this song. I sang it with my dad when we sang in Graceway 18, 20 years ago. It always brought me great comfort, and it still does. And I hope it'll bring you comfort tonight. As a Christian, as a child of God, you don't have to fear. Just cling to Jesus.
Sacrificial offering. He was beaten beyond recognition, bruised, spat upon, humiliated, beyond anything we could ever imagine. He was buried in a borrowed tomb because he was only going to need it for 3 days. He's alive and well today. Amen?
Amen.
And that's why we sing these songs and we proclaim. And it was so encouraging to see these young people up here this afternoon,
yes,
worshiping and leading the music, because that lets you know that's a healthy church. You got young folks that are involved in leadership positions. Fantastic piano playing. And the guy, we call him the fiddle. You may call him the violin, but we call him the fiddle. But fantastic. I could hear him accentuating and complimenting the chords, and it was awesome. So kudos to the musicians and the singers, and what a blessing they have been just while we were sitting here enjoying these songs this evening. But we want to sing this song for you right now. That's simply entitled The Resurrection.
It was the first day of his death since he had taken his last breath. Sorrow filled the air, the birds stopped singing everywhere. Nothing seemed the same, the clouds began to weep the rain.
Hear the cries from the
there's no key. See the tears of the broken, the cries of the slave. Is there no one worthy to set us free? Then the cry is stilled as that chorus rings out. The shackled released from their chains. Thousands of voices join in the song. Was
to the praise team and the singers and the musicians. What a What a blessing. What a way to for us to, yeah. Special thanks to our dear special friends that help us along the way. They're so special. We appreciate them. Carol and Rachel, y'all know. Has there anybody got anything on their heart and mind at all? Anybody here got anything they want to say?
The best is yet to come.
Amen. The best is yet to come.
Amen.
Amen. Come on, Brother Travis.
I'll give him another hand. Go ahead.
That was good. Amen. I enjoyed that a lot. Let's get a couple ushers to come up, maybe three of you. I got to get back to North Carolina, so y'all help them along the way. Amen. It'll be a blessing to them, and hope to have them come back and minister to us again. And stand to your feet. Would you do that? And what we'll do is we'll pray for the offering. As the offering is passed, you're free to go. Y'all don't have CDs and things yet, do you?
Not yet.
But next time.
Next time.
Amen. We enjoyed it so much. Thank God. Well, Brother Tim, bless the offering. Bless the group as they leave. Watch over them. Protect them. Pray for them, too.
Father.